Let That Be Your Last Battlefield caused quite the battle behind the scenes. Most Star Trek story outlines could not be turned into scripts without the final approval of the NBC executives. During the first season of the series, Gene Kuhn submitted an outline called Portrait of Black and White. It was rejected by the network executives and further escalated the mounting tension between Gene Roddenberry and NBC. Now, fast forward to season three. With severely reduced budgets and eroding network confidence in the series, there was a major change in philosophy. Now the powers that be would no longer reject scripts based on their content, but on how much they would cost to produce. Once money was spent on a project, good or bad, it was seen through to its end. This story outline that had been lying around for 2 years was turned into a script by Oliver Crawford. So, now let's see what became of Let That Be Your Last Battlefield. Frank Gorshin, the illustrious celebrity impressionist, plays Beale in this episode. Gorshin was a familiar face to television audiences through his portrayal of the Riddler in the Batman TV series. The cinematography techniques supplied by Al Francis in this episode were pretty innovative. Check out the transporter sequence, where the camera is actually placed on the platform rather than the control console. It's one of the first point-of-view shots to ever be used in the series. The inhabitants of Sharon have destroyed each other due to their senseless, unending hatred. Herein lies a lesson in the futility of prejudice. Think back to 1969 when racial tension hit an all-time high. The battle cry was to respect your fellow man regardless of race, color, or creed. Let That Be Your Last Battlefield may have suffered from being too preachy and too simplistic in its treatment of the black and white issue, but its heart was truly in the right place.